Well, that was pretty good, but let's let the people out there on the street hear us. How about that? Good evening. Amen. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Well, it's so good to have you here tonight, and hopefully we'll still keep having a few more come on in. That's all right, too. But I do want to thank you and welcome you for being here at Covington Church. We're so excited to have you here and to be a part of the service tonight with Brother Reggie and his family. I'll let him do all the introductions on that in a few minutes. Some of you don't need introductions with him, probably. But for those who do, I'm going to let him handle that. But I do want to just say thank you so very much. So to kind of let you know how tonight's going to go a little bit, I want to give you a little bit of an order. So we're going to, in just a moment, we'll have an opening prayer to get us started. I'm going to have Cecil, is he outside? Oh, there he is. Cecil Cottrell with Mount Jubilee Ministries. He's going to come up and give a short presentation on what they do and how it impacts local churches on what they do. And, of course, their camp is part of the Wesleyan camp. Is that right? No? Where's your camp? So they get support from the Wesleyan churches too, though, I think. How about that? Okay. I had three hot dogs, you can tell, right? I'm not thinking clearly at the moment. But he's going to come up in just a moment, and he's going to talk for just a few minutes about that. And then tonight we're going to have a wonderful MC, Mr. Dave Compton. And then we have tonight on our piano, Miss Hermine Heller. She did a good prelude. I got to get it right. Music prelude for you just a few minutes ago. She's a wonderful pianist. And so we're hoping that you'll enjoy tonight's services. We will be taking up shortly one offering for the church. But at the end, when you get ready to exit, there'll be love offering buckets out at the door on these two doors right here. Okay? So please be sure and provide, if you would please, to Reggie and the family. And they have such wonderful stuff out there to look at. Also, be sure and visit their table if you hadn't already before you leave. And be sure and visit the Mount Jubilee's ministry when they get ready to go back out there as well. And so I think I've done enough of talking. It's time to get the show on the road. What do you think? All right. Well, let's open in prayer. Father, we thank you, Lord, for this wonderful day. We thank you for the blessings. We thank you for just allowing us the time to come together in fellowship and worship and song and music and who knows, Lord, maybe even some word will be part of tonight's service. Thank you, Father, for all you're doing in our lives. Thank you, Father, for your provisions and your grace and your love of your Son Jesus to us, who we would not have anything if it wasn't for him. Thank you, Lord, for all your blessings upon us and all the churches represented here tonight. For I ask this in Christ's name. Amen. All right, Brother Cecil, you're on. The clock is ticking. When the mic goes dead, you're done.
You good? Good evening. So, I was a little taken back when the brother said maybe even a little word will come forth tonight. So why don't we just start with, for God so loved the world that he gave. Now, we've gotten that out of the way, brother. Whatever else comes is gravy, but we've gotten that out of the way. Okay. Mount Jubilee Ministries. If anybody heard of it, raise your hand. Okay, now, if you haven't heard of it, raise your hand. Love that. We're going to change that over the next 9 minutes and 30 seconds. Mount Jubilee Ministries was started in 2005 as an effort to put on a residential summer camp for children with special needs, with intellectual developmental disabilities. Those kids, for 10 years, we did Camp Jubilee, and we watched those kids grow up, and they graduated from high school, and guess what? There was nothing out there for them to do. These kids talked about Camp Jubilee from the day they left Camp Jubilee in the summer till the day they came back, and the leadership of Mount Jubilee Ministry said, we need them to enjoy that year-round. So after 10 years of just camp, the leadership of MJM said, we've got to do something different, and or do more is what we thought. So in about 2015, we announced to about 200 people that MJM was going to go from a camp ministry to a residential community, because that's the biggest fear of every parent of someone with a special child with a special needs. What's going to happen to my child when I'm gone? Who's going to take care of it? So we wanted to begin building that foundation, building that vision of a residential community. Well, we realized real quick that you can't just go from a camp ministry to a residential community. Mike Wright's hammer doesn't work that fast. You didn't think I knew you were there, did you, brother? His hammer doesn't work that fast. But at any rate, the foundation began to be laid in 2016 when MJM hired me to become the first part-time employee. And by the grace of God, he appointed or orchestrated a nationally renowned consultant to work side by side with me pro bono for 3 years. For 2016 to 2019, there she was, everything I needed. She taught me how to board development, committee structure, marketing, fundraising, you name it, anything having to do with a nonprofit, she taught us how to do it. She flew away in 19 just like she flew in 16. And in December of 2019, we opened His Path Developmental Day Program in Rockingham County. And 3 months later, of course, we, like everybody else, shut down for the season because of COVID. We reopened in 2020. And the Lord, we had a little different model in 2020 when we reopened, and the Lord has seen fit to bless this organization in ways that we would have never imagined. We have launched a second program over in Winston-Salem in 21, and in summer of 22, we launched a third program in Greensboro. We're partnering with local churches for their space. You know, a lot of this building stays empty during the week, right? Most churches do. So that's what our goal is. Our model is to partner with churches for inexpensive or free space to have day programs. We plan to continue to expand, but we're trying to catch our breath right now, to be honest with you. It's been a large amount of expansion. We're serving over 45 or 50 families in the Piedmont Triad year-round now. And Heather is one of those heroes. We call them our His Path heroes. She comes here in Reidsville, and I know her to be the Uno queen, but I think she just wanted to say a little bit about His Path. What do you want to tell them?
I was going to say that we go on field trips too, and I love doing that too.
What about the greeting cards?
And we do a greeting cards.
Heather said they're doing greeting cards. We are modeling after an organization in Texas. It's called Brookwood in Georgetown, Texas. And they recognize that our special friends have the ability to do a lot of beautiful and good stuff, created to create. And we are going to begin and have begun incorporating an enterprise arm to our His Path Day program. We are making greeting cards. We'll go into the baking business. We'll do candles. We'll do acrylic pours with
cutting boards.
And what?
Cutting boards.
That's right. And the handles will have acrylic paint on them, and they're beautiful. But we just recognize that the world. We have a lot to offer the world, and that's one of our taglines, is changing the way the world views our friends with disabilities or special needs. Another tagline is that adults with special needs contribute to the world, and that's what we want to do, is to allow in every opportunity to partner with these wonderful folks. We would encourage you as a local church, when we first started raising funds back in 2016, the slideshow said, Mount Jubilee Ministries, where faith and the local church meet. we can't do this without a ton of grassroots funding. And that's what's happened over the last 8 years. We started our Family Fun Walk. I'm going to tell you a little more about that. 8 years ago, $30,000 goal right here in downtown Reidsville. And we reached it. We have raised and exceeed our goal for seven consecutive years, with this year's goal coming in at $200,000. And we're going to pass it on September 9th by the grace of God. And Heather is going to have, she's going to be a part of that fundraising effort by having Team Heather.
Team Heather.
Go Team Heather. And I would imagine that Pastor Jimmy's going to give her the opportunity to pass out some pledge cards here and tell you more about that. That will go live on our website and registration Tuesday, Lord willing, for the registration. It's September 9th. Would like to invite all of you to come out and be a part of that. We're expecting about 300 people. And again, you'll hear a lot more about it. I've got flyers on the table that I'll hand out as we go, as you go out. Is my 10 minutes up? It is. I want to just tell you that the residential community that we dreamed of many years ago is still very much in the forefront of our minds. God has opened and closed the door on several pieces of property, and we're looking at another piece of property right now. And we would ask you to pray with us as we continue to seek His will in what we're going to do to better serve our special friends. Thank you so much.
I love you, Mama.
Yay, Mama. More. Yay.
Cecil's my good friend, and our church at Lawsonville Road Baptist, we support Mount Jubilee, and it's a wonderful cause, and I hope that the Lord will just continue to bless them. Well, it is good to be back at Covington Wesleyan Church. Now, when I was here some 12 years. If you were here back in those days, kind of wave your hand at me so I can see you. Welcome. Welcome, welcome. I'm so glad to see all of you here. We had some good days back in the 90s, in the early 2000s. It was just a wonderful experience for me, and I'm really glad to be back home. Good to see you. God bless you. All right. Well, tell you what, let's do that song, Steve. And then we'll do a little congregational, but I just felt led to sing this song tonight. Somebody's praying, I can feel it. Somebody's praying for me. Mighty hands are guiding me to protect me from what I can't see. Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. Somebody's praying for me. How many believes that? Amen. Here's what else we believe. Angels are watching. I can feel it. Angels are watching over me. Many miles ahead till I get home. Yet I'm safely kept before God's throne. Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. Angels are watching over me. Well, I've walked the barren wilderness where my pillow was a stone. I've been through the darkest caverns where no night has ever shone. Still I went on
because there was someone down on my knees. Lord, I thank you for these people praying all this time for me. Somebody's praying, I can feel it. Somebody's praying for me. Mighty hands are guiding me to protect me from what I can't see. Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. Somebody's praying for me. Somebody's praying for me. And Jesus is our advocate, and he prays for you and I, making intercession with the Father. If you love him, give him a big hand tonight. Amen, amen. Well, in the years that I was at Covington, I used to come do the announcements at the very outset of all of the services. And so when we would get through, does anybody remember what we would sing? I'm so glad I'm a part of the... You remember? We sang it every Sunday here for years and years. So let's sing that. Hear me? I want you to sing in your best voice, real good and loud, okay?
I'm so glad I'm a part of the family of God. I've been washed in the fountain, cleansed by his blood. Joy tears with Jesus as we for I'm part of the family of God.
Now, I just have a sneaky suspicion that some of you were not singing your best. I just kind of feel it right here, so let me get a little closer. Let's do it again. Let's really make the house ring tonight, okay? Are you ready? Here we go.
I'm so glad I'm a part of the family of God. I've been washed in the fountain.
I hear you.
The family.
A big hand. All right. For those that do not know me, I'm Dave Compton with the Truth Network on radio station WPET in Greensboro, and I'm glad to let you know that we now have the stations in Madison, Mayodan, Eden, and in Reidsville. The Truth Network is here on 1490 AM, 1420 AM, and here in Reidsville, FM 92.5. So I hope that you'll give a listen to some of the wonderful programming that we have, and we believe it'll be a blessing to you. Reggie Sadler and his family are here tonight. Now, the last time that Reggie and the family and I were together was in COVID. We did a fundraiser in Burlington for the Piedmont Rescue Mission, and they wouldn't let nobody in but just those that were participating. Remember that, Reggie? So it was broadcast on the internet, and despite the fact that they didn't let anybody in, We raised thousands of dollars that night, thousands on top of thousands for the Piedmont Rescue, and Reggie and his family were so gracious to come and to share with us that night. It was a wonderful experience, but it was kind of strange, no audience out there. So, name, rank, and serial number.
Name, rank, Reginald Garfield Sadler, 2436691. Amen.
Fought in Vietnam. You were in Vietnam.
Vietnam, 1966 to 68. Artillery stationed around Saigon. And love my country. Amen. And
we're thankful for your service. Amen. Amen. So this is Reggie. This is Sugar Babe. Yes. Tell everybody hello.
Hello.
We're glad. Name, rank, and serial number. Oh, you don't have one. Okay. We're so glad to have you, Miss Sandler.
Thank you.
And this young lady here, this is the daughter of the Sadlers. What's her name?
Ingra. I'm Ingra.
Okay, Ingra.
Ingra, yes.
Okay. It's name, rank, and serial number.
My name is Ingra.
Don't give your social security number. Don't do that. But I want to, I want you to know that I love the Sadlers. And Reggie and I'll tell you what, on my worst day, he makes me have the best day if we get on the phone together. It's a blessing. I so appreciate the Sadlers. How many has never heard the Sadlers in person? Oh, my, Reggie, we're going to plow some new ground tonight. So I'm so glad that I had the glorious opportunity to introduce them to you for the very first time. So would you please make welcome the Reggie Sadler family to Covington Wesleyan Church. Let's hear it.
I like to enter the gates with thanksgiving, of course, with praise. Let's just do that now. To the Lord Jesus Christ. Everybody. Oh, we get you now, honey. Let me walk you down. Help me now.
Oh, what a fellowship, what a joy divine. Leaning on the everlasting arm.
You can sing it now.
What a blessedness, what a peace mine. Leaning on the everlasting arm. Leaning on Jesus Christ.
Yes, sir, I'm leaning. Yes, I'm safe
and secure. They tell me of a home far beyond the skies. Oh, they tell me of a home far away. Oh, they tell me of a home where no storm clouds rise. Oh, they tell me of an unclouded day.
Come on, help me now.
Oh, the land of cloudless day. Oh, the land of an unclouded sky. Oh, they tell me of a home where no storm clouds rise.
That's right.
Oh, they tell me of an unclouded day.
I don't know the day, I don't know the hour, but one of these days now,
some
come on,
when this life is over, I'll
morning.
Some glad.
A big ending, everybody. Amen. If you're breathing, you ought to be praising him. I tell you what, I want you to pucker up and look toward heaven and go like this. Mm-hmm. Oh, he loves it. He loves it. Don't you love the Lord Jesus? Amen. Everything that has breath ought to praise the Lord. Amen. God is so good. We thank him. We adore him. We bless him. Proverbs 18:24 says, he who hath friends must show himself friend. If you're friendly, wave at me. Amen. Amen. The way you acquire friends is you've got to be friendly. Amen. I tell you, God's people ought to be the friendliest people. I tell you, the pastor met me, Pastor Jimmy Davis. I thought he was the governor of Tennessee. But anyway, Pastor Davis met me. This is how he met me when I came up to Covington today. I said, dear Lord, I might change my membership. My pastor greets me like this. You sorry rascal. No, he doesn't. No, my pastor loves me, and we're good friends. I love my preacher. Don't you thank God for preachers and Sunday school teachers? Amen. I have three girls. I adore my girls. Love them so much. I told them, when you get married, the man you marry must be born again. Number two, the man you marry must have a job. Amen. Number three, the man you marry ought to have his clothes up on him. I want my baby daughter now. I love my baby daughter. I appreciate her. She leads worship at the Epic Church in Gastonia, and he pulled a big one to get them out of retirement. To get them back together as a family. They don't go out a whole lot, but we decided to come down for the preaching, and he pulled us out. Amen. But I want my daughter, and I want you to listen. Don't do this. Don't quench the spirit. Hello. I'm delivering the mail. You got to go to the mailbox sometime. Listen, don't quench the spirit. Do this. Now, if you can't say amen, do this. If you can't do that and you can't say amen, do this. And if you can't do that one, here's another one for you. Amen. It's good. Did you know that laughter is like a medicine? I mean, it's going to be some healing in here tonight, all this laughter. It's good to see some happy Christians for a change. Amen. Let's haul off and give God praise one more time. Let's do it. Let's do it, Covington. Covington, let's do it. Amen. Let's do it. Look, Lord, let's do it. Jesus. Amen. Whoopee. I want my daughter. Now you shout glory, hallelujah, amen. I want her to sing this song for me.
In Christ alone. My hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song.
That's my baby.
This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears have stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness. By the ones he came to save, till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied for every sin.
on him was laid. Here in the death of Christ I live. Yes, I live in Christ alone.
Let's give him praise one more time. You can't praise him enough, church. Amen.
There in the ground his body lay, light of the world by darkness slain, then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again, and as he stands in victory, since curse has lost its grip on me, for I am his and he is mine. I'm bought with the precious blood of Christ, and on Christ the solid rock I stand. All of the ground is sinking sand. All of the ground is sinking sand. On Christ the solid rock I stand. All of the ground is sinking sand. All of the ground is sinking sand. No guilt in no fear in death. This is the power of Christ in me. From my first cry till final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power of hell, no scheme of man could ever pluck me from his hand. Calls me home. Here in the death of Christ I live.
Baby girl Ingra. From the Bill Gates of videos, let's shout it out, Covington. I've got me a home. Woo! Wanna dedicate this to my main man, the legendary Dave Thompson. Amen.
Oh, I've got me a home.
I've got me a home.
Got me a home.
Got me a home.
Got me a home.
I've got me a home not made by hands.
Got me a home.
I've got me a home in heaven on high. I've got me a home way beyond the sky.
I'm gonna see my Jesus. Worship him.
Gonna worship him all day long.
We're gonna worship him.
Gonna worship him with a new song.
Go
gonna
on
to worship all day long. As we gather around the throne, gonna worship him when I get home.
We're gonna walk that street.
Gonna walk, gonna walk.
Through the wheelchair.
Gonna
way.
Walk, gonna keep on walking.
You're gonna go walk that golden street. Street.
Someday
you're gonna
walk those streets of gold as eternity rolls.
Gonna
walk those golden streets when I get home.
I've got me a home.
I've got me a home. I've got me a home.
I've got it. I've got it. I've got it.
Not made by hands.
Got me a home.
I've got me a home in heaven on high. I've got me a home.
Let me tell you,
my heavenly
just a little bit more of that. Amen. I've got me a home.
I've got me a home.
I can't hear
I've
you.
I've got me a home.
If you don't have a church home, boy, we got a seat for you right here. Amen. And don't forget that the Bible says, whosoever. I like this whosoever gospel, don't you? That means you. That means me. That means rich. That means poor. That means Hispanic. That means black. That means whosoever. Amen. Will trust on the Lord Jesus. It didn't say whosoever feels. Whosoever would trust and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ. Hey, I like it around here. I came in, they got babies everywhere. I like it. Keep them coming, darling. Amen. Fill up these pews. Amen. Amen, amen, and amen. I love my precious wife. I thank God for her. What a blessing. She's my business manager. She's my wife. She does everything. I tell you, I love Sugar Babe so much. She's in love, too. I want the queen of the saddler's household to come around now and sing one for us called The Strength of the Lord. You take a listen, amen.
Sometimes life seems like words and music that can't quite become a song. So we cry and sigh, and we try again, and wonder what could be wrong. But when we turn to the Lord at the end of ourselves, like we've done a time or two before, we find His truth is the same as it's always been. Yep. We never will need more. It's not in trying, but in trusting. It's not in running, but in resting. It's not in wandering, but in praying, that we find the strength of the Lord. It's not in trying, but in trusting. It's not in running, but in resting. It's not in wandering, but in praying, that we find the strength of the Lord. Go if we choose to live a life on our own, then the only good that will ever be said of the pains we find ourselves in, they are places to gain the wisdom to say, I'll never leave him again. It's not in trying, but in trusting. Not in running, but in resting. It's not in wandering, but in praying, that we find the strength of the Lord. It's not in trying, but in trusting. It's not in running, but in resting. It's not in wandering, but in praying, that we find the strength of the Lord. It's not in wandering, but in praying, that we find the strength of the Lord. We find the strength of the Lord.
Oh. Here's a song that did real well for us, and we appreciate it. Thank you for playing our music too, Brother Dave. God bless you. Amen. If I had $1 million, I'd give you something. Yeah. Come on, Covington. Hey.
I've got it.
Yeah.
I've got the real thing, Jesus in my life.
I've got me a brand new walk. Yes, sir. Even changed the way that I talk.
Been sanctified and set aside.
I've got Jesus
in my life.
I've got me a brand new smile. Ever since I walked down the aisle right now,
I'm as happy as a little child.
Woo-hoo.
Jesus in my life.
First thing in the morning,
I'm giving you praises.
And all
there's no one above you. You are the Lord. Do you want a brand new walk?
Do you want a brand new way to talk?
Do you
want
to be sanctified and set aside?
You need
Jesus in your life.
First thing in the morning. Before your coffee, before your donuts.
There's no one above you. You are the Lord.
You're in heaven now. Come on now.
I've got it.
And everybody over here say, I've got it. Okay, cheer up. I've got it. Yes, I've got the real thing.
Jesus in my life. And that's the real thing. Jesus in my life.
Let's hear it for the preacher. I've got it. That's not real. Brother Dave, brother.
I've got it.
Okay, right here, this dude.
I've got it.
Oh, this sounds pretty good, don't it?
Oh, Jesus in my life. And that's the real thing. Jesus in my life. And that's the real thing.
I've got it.
Jesus in my life.
Hey, you
love
birds.
That's the real thing. Jesus in my life.
And that's the real thing. Give him praise again. Let's adore him. Let's hear for the sound crew, the tech. Boy, they're doing a great job over there. Thank you so much. We get your check in the mail, okay? In a little town called Bethlehem, so many years ago, they told him there was no room in the inn. Brother Dave, they had no way of knowing whom they had just turned. It was the Lamb of God who would take away their sin. If you know this part, sing it with me. I'm glad I know who Jesus is. Anybody? Yes, I'm glad I know. Sing that with this in mind. This guitar been around the world with me. Switzerland, Japan. This, you know, one time, I'm going to give you just a little bit of my testimony. The pastor said, dump the whole load right here. B.B. King wanted to sign this guitar one time. I was at the Wilshire Boulevard Theater in Los Angeles, and I wouldn't let him sign it. I said, you're not mark up my guitar. Oh, but I did. Now, before I became a Christian, my mother, bless her heart, and I caused my mother trouble. I was a bad little boy. I didn't know the Lord then. But my mother, now I've got a DVD out there, Honey Heaven. We got the Live in Tallahassee. Yeah, I think I've got some of my videos out here. Not a lot, but you can pick this up. I won't do the entirety of it tonight. Can everybody understand me? Sometimes I talk a little fast. Everybody understand? If you understand me, throw your credit card up here. I was like, oh, what did you say, Mac? What did you say, Mac? But let me give you, my mother never smiled much. She was one of the saddest women on planet Earth. My mother, and I did things to try to make Mama happy. And one of the few times my mother smiled was when Ed Sullivan come on. How many remember Ed Sullivan? Way back, oh man, way back. Ed Sullivan would come on, and my mama told us, my mother married one, two, three. Well, we couldn't keep a dad around the house. And my mother didn't want to be alone. My mother told us that she had a boyfriend. She said her boyfriend was Elvis Presley. We believed her. You don't doubt Mommy. And we thought, oh, Mama's got a boyfriend. And when Ed Sullivan would come on, now ladies, you help me. Ladies, when you see me shake this leg right here, I want the ladies only. I mean, if you're not sure about your job, well, ladies only. ladies, when you see me shake this leg, I want the ladies, I want you to go, whoa, 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 ah, you know, let your hair down, take it off, throw it up here, tell me. We'll give it back. But I'm going to show you what Mama did. Now, I'm going to show you. And when you see me shake the lake, I mean, let her, just let her go. We're saved. Amen. Going to heaven. Okay. Oh, Elvis would come on, and my mother would say, now, I want you youngins to be quiet. My boyfriends are coming on. And when she told us to be quiet, we would say, Mommy, can we get a cookie while you're watching your boy? You know, trying to trick Mommy. But Elvis would come on. Let me show you what he would do. Hold up, ladies. Men, get a hold of them. Hold on. Thank you very much. I could do one of my big ones now. Dedicate this to Mama. Preacher, come on, I done flushed them out, boy. And Mama would be kissing the TV. And we'd be hollering, Daddy, come home, we hungry, you know. She was real fluffy, you know. But then I was adopted. I was adopted by this family and used to play what we call beach music. How many of you ever heard of beach music before? How many of you ever been to Myrtle Beach before? Some of you, it didn't take. Go again. You know, you got to get it like mine. All right, go again. All right. Here we go. Myrtle Beach. If you haven't been to Myrtle Beach, yeah, beach music goes like this. We have beach music, and beach music goes like this. Dum 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 dum. Beach music goes like this. Say, there's someone to shag back there. Hold on. And beach music. I've got sunshine on a cloudy day. Uh-oh, what have you done? Boy, I told you about smoking in church. Lighten up on him, brother. Lighten up on him. It's good to see some smiling Christians. You don't know how good this is. And listen, I used to do beach music, and I used to do some country, too. Watch this. Y'all want a little sugar? Listen, our music was different back then. You know, our music was different. Our music had a different feel. How many remember songs like this? You know, back, I mean, it wasn't talking about killing, it wasn't talking about murder. Our song was like this. And I'm Brother Reggie, why would you do that? I'm just trying to, that was my before Christ. Hello. But I did. I played all that music and our music was soon. I can remember my mother listening to Eddie Arnold. She'd be crying sometime. Eddie Arnold would be singing. Make the world go away. And young people, I worked for Disney World for 10 years. Young people, the little babies right there, the ones that are awake. Yeah, okay. Have you ever heard a chicken and a guitar? Listen, a chicken and a guitar, daughter, just for you. Watch it now. Here we go. She likes it. She likes it. She likes it, preacher. She likes me, but I'm married. I'm sorry. Okay, one more time. Chicken and a guitar. Now watch this, baby. Here's the chicken playing. Here's the chicken playing in the water. Watch. How about that? Now you're really gonna like this. I don't know. You ladies right there, y'all might wanna write. Listen, tie your hair up in a little bob. How about a chicken on a Harley Davidson? A chicken on a Harley. Boy, I'm going to try to listen. A chicken on a Harley Davidson. First of all, you put your helmet on. Say your prayers. Get you some insurance. If you can afford it. Okay, a chicken on a Harley. Here we go. Must be cheap gas. Ain't no cheap gas in Reedsville. I looked all over this place. Okay, chicken on a Harley. Here we go now. Want to ride chicken, baby? Listen, all over Japan, Switzerland, working, starting in Disneyland, and then down to Disney World. I tell you, and backed up all of the Red Fox. I used to open for Red Fox at the Thunderbird Hotel. Flew my family out to hear them. They stayed about 15 minutes and had to leave. But Red Fox used to tell Esther, he said, Esther, you so ugly when you cry. Tears go down your back, keep them crossing your ugly face, you know. But I work with all of those. All the people, listen. And Dick Clark's Rock and Roll Revival, Dick Clark was one of the nicest guys you ever want to meet. But listen, let me remind you, nice people don't go to heaven. Saved people go to heaven. But there I was. Just a little old fellow out there, getting ready to go to Johnny Carson, having a big old time. I tell you, I was having a time. And I thought, man, I'm going to be a big star. Mama's going to be proud of me. I'm going to make money. I'm going to buy a house. I'm going to buy a Cadillac. And I got out there, and I'm ashamed to say, started making good money, and I forgot about my dear old mom. I would send her a few dollars every now and then. But you see, I spent my money trying to keep up with the high life in California. I used Elvis Presley backup band at the Las Vegas Hilton. Oh, the place my feet have trod, the things my eyes have seen. And to think that while I was rocking and rolling, God had made plans for my soul. Boy, that's why I love him so much. Traveling, working with old Bo Diddley, oh, the people, Jerry Lee Lewis. Jerry Lee Lewis was a mean man. I think he cooled down a little bit, and you know, before he went out of here. But anyway, I don't like to talk about my old guys, because I was out there. I was one of them. Such has been some of us. Amen. But there I was. And listen, here's, oh boy, I got to hurry. Y'all got to amen faster. Here you go. Here's one. If I get this one right, you let me know, okay? Now, if I get it right, you let me know, okay? If it ain't right, you tell me. Okay, if I get it right. Watch this. I bet you can't do this. I can play it with my teeth. I can't wait to see it myself. Well, I used to, but they come out now. But I used to. I used to be hard on it, boy. Oh, I was out there. You said, well, what happened, Brother Reggie, through all of that? Listen, my name used to be on the marquee, had Bill Cosby up, and then my name. And I thought, my. And I'd be sleeping in Las Vegas Hilton Hotel up there, used Elvis Presley backup band, Joe Guercio directing Elvis band. And by the way, Joe Guercio got saved, Elvis music director, band director. He got saved and started doing gospel music. Amen. And a lot of the guys, some of the guys in Earth, Wind, and Fire used to hang out with, they got saved. And I tell you, a lot of them, God will save anybody. And there I was having a great time. I'm the head of my house. She just run it. Isn't that the way it is? Oh, my. You're looking at a fella who thanks God Praise God. I want to do this song now. And I want you to take a listen. Thank you, honey. I want to dedicate this to my good friend, Pastor Davis. When I think how Jesus came so far from glory, came to dwell among the lowly, such as I, to suffer shame and such disgrace. On Mount Calvary, he would take our place. Then I asked myself this question: who am I? Who am I that a great king would bleed and die for? Who am I that he would pray not my will but thine will? Thank you, honey.
The answer I gave her.
Why ever? I don't understand. To an old rugged cross he would go. Who am I? For you, my brother. Listen. Then I'm reminded of his words: I will leave you never. If you be true, I'll give unto you life forever and ever. I know there's nothing that I could have done, baby girl, to deserve God's own begotten Son, to fight our battles until they are won. Who am I? Bleed and die for. Who am I that he would pray not Thank you. Just be seated and we'll get ready and get you out of here. I think it's about time for Gunsmoke. All right. I want couple and then we're going to get y'all. Boy, if y'all hadn't been nice, we'd have left 30 minutes ago. I want to thank God for the, if you've served in the United States Army or the National Guard, would you stand right quick and give me a sharp salute? If you served in the National Guard or United States Army, come on, men, turn, hut! Let's thank God for them, amen. Thank you, sir. Anyone here from the United States Navy? Navy, would you stand? We love our Navy boys. If not, I'll stand for the Navy. Okay, Navy. Let's hear for them. Navy. United States Coast Guard, are you here? I represent Coast Guard. All right, let's hear for them. My daughter served with them just for a while. The United States Air Force, fly it high, boys. Air Force, are you here? Air Force, I'll salute for them, too. Now, this next group, bunch of mama's boys. This month, I think they're preaching a sale on Girl Scout cookies. Oh, we've got some in our church. But ladies and gentlemen, when you wrap it up and put it all together, let's hear for the fighting United States Jarhead Marines. Marines, would you stand? There he is back there. I knew we had one in the book. All it takes is one. Amen. And now, let's thank God for our sheriff. Let's thank God for our sheriff, police force. Amen. What about, ladies and gentlemen, these guys are weird. Something's wrong in the head. When they holler fire, we run that away. But when we holler fire, they run to the fire. Let's hear for our firemen! Firemen back there, thank God. Anybody here from the sheriff, police department? Yeah, nobody. He didn't want to stand up. He gave me a t- Yeah, all right, okay. Back there, all right. Get him in here, all right. All right. While they're doing that, let's hear for our doctors and nurses. Okay. Okay, Sheriff Department right here. All right, let's hear it, Sheriff Department. Hey, you're the one gave me that ticket. I pay it Tuesday, all right. All right, thank God for them, amen. Appreciate them. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the last one we want to thank, let's thank God for, not the last one, but our Sunday school teachers. Let's thank God for our Sunday school teachers. What about our beloved pastor? Do we love him, Pastor David? And now, this next one, never lost a battle. Never lost a battle. They even tried to kill. They even hung him on a cross. They even put him in a borrowed tomb. Ladies and gentlemen, the King of Glory, our Lord and our Savior, Jesus Christ, he's never lost a battle. He's the King of Glory. Woohoo! Amen. Boy, what a Savior. What a Savior. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Amen. I'd like to do this next one. You got it, baby. Amen. Here's one my family like to do. We wrote this years ago. On behalf of Pastor Davis and Covington Wesleyan Church, Lord God Almighty, we want to thank you. We love you, Lord. Thank you for our service. Veterans in the hospital bed, you and I living real good,
but many good soldiers dead. The old red, white, and blue,
yes sir,
the colors of our land.
Divided we fall, but together we can stand.
The old red, white, and blue,
all the blood that was shared, you and I, living with you.
But many good soldiers dead.
with God.
We'll fight till we die.
And we'll never
retreat.
Good hearts will stay here. You and I live in the wilderness.
But many good soldiers say, the old red, white, and blue.
Yes, sir. We ought to take time, church, and thank the Lord for the good old USA. Oh, the land of the free, the soldiers they cry.
One nation under God, we'll fight till we die.
And we'll never
retreat.
Keep
marching straight ahead.
In case you don't know, again, I appreciate my girl. Appreciate. Have you enjoyed baby girl tonight, Ingram? Ingram leads worship, as I said, at a church in Gastonia, North Carolina, and she works for one of the best banks in North Carolina. She works at a bank about 7 minutes from home, and she's got a good job there, a lot of benefits. I appreciate and love my baby. Again, let's thank God for baby girl. I mean, Ingra, all right. And the queen of the Saddler's household, yabba dabba doo. She's my honey, she's my darling. I love her so much. Can I have a little of sugar? Yahoo! Every time she kissed me, I want to say, wow, thing. She's the queen of the Saddler's household. She's finished, went back and got her degree, business degree at Liberty University. She's my business manager, keeps my stuff going, designing my website. She, listen, takes care of my taxes, keeps my everything going. She's my honey. She's my darling. I appreciate and love her so much. I call her Sugar Babe. Her name is Bridget. You happy to see her tonight, honey? My name is Pastor Jim Davis. Amen. Let's hear for old Reggie over here. I'll clean your old clock. Y'all got out without me preaching tonight, so. But anyway, love you. We enjoyed it so much. Don't forget to stop by the table and pick up. Oh, I didn't even do anything for my new CD. Even if you don't like it, buy it. You don't have to like it. Just buy it, support it. And anything you give will help to feed hungry children, my grandbabies. And I do want to say that Wednesday, we were involved with the group down at UDAS Special Needs. And I was just there Wednesday. We had about 98 of them in Monroe, North Carolina, UDI. And I go down there, and they make flagpoles and things. But I love them. We had a time. They were twisting and shouting, Elvis, Johnny Be Good. And they're just a happy bunch. But I appreciate them. One of the big songs for the Saddler family was Anytime, Anyplace, Anywhere. We're going to do this one. And I can do that one. Here it is. Let's give God praise one more time. If you're not saved by the grace of God, here's your opportunity. If we confess our sins, he's faithful and just to forgive.
I know a man who can walk on water anytime, any place, anywhere.
And I know a man who can calm a storm anytime, any place, anywhere.
I know a man who can raise the dead anytime, any place, anywhere.
And I know a man who can open blind eyes anytime, any place, anywhere.
In a storm, he'll meet you there anytime, any place, anywhere. Rain or shine, he's on time. Anywhere.
I know a man who can feed 5,000 anytime, any place, anywhere.
With just 5 loaves and 2 little fish anytime, any place, anywhere.
In a storm, you'll meet you there anytime, any place, anywhere. Rain or shine. On time, any place, anywhere.
And I know a man who can save anybody anytime, any place, anywhere. I know a man who can meet your needs anytime, any place, anywhere.
In a storm, he'll meet you there anytime, any place, anywhere. Rain or shine,
rain
it's on time.
Everybody, a big wave, show yourself friendly. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Let's hear it for the Sadler family. Now, I have to tell you, ladies, I went through a whole lot with him to get y'all here tonight, and I know that. I heard him 2 months up on White Oak Mountain and wearing a pair of blue jean overalls, and I said, no, they got to have the rest of them back.
Amen, bro.
Wasn't they great? Give it to them again. Come on. We got your water somewhere. I don't know what we did with it, but okay. So what I would like to do, first of all, if I can get our ushers, if we can get our ushers, somebody may have to go back out because they're probably playing security. That's how deputies go when they get together. Come on, fellas. They said, us? Yeah. Thank you, Mike. So first of all, we're going to take up an offering that we normally would do for the church. But at the end, and come on up, Miss Hermine. She's so wonderfully talented playing our piano. We're going to give you a little bit of a break at the moment here. Okay.
Yeah, I'm done.
Oh,
okay, whatever you say.
No, you're not done. We want an encore, don't we? We might need intermission and have you back up here.
Oh, you better tell them.
But, so we're going to take up our regular offering. But at the end of the service, we're going to have people standing outside here with the buckets, if you would, for love offering for them. Because I want you to think of it this way. Now, they came up here from Monroe. Wonderful time tonight we've had with them. And I want you to do better than Peter did when he saw Jesus walking on the water. Peter wanted to get out of the boat and go join him, didn't he? And Peter, what did he do? He started off really good. But then all of a sudden, the world distractions around Peter, the storms and the lightning, took his eyes off Jesus. And what happened? Peter started to sink. Tonight, I want you to understand that they came here on the faith of knowing that we're going to help them. And I don't want you to let them down, please. So please try to help provide, buy something from them. But when it comes time to give them on their love offering, if you would, please reach deep and help them for us. Okay, so we got our regular offering ushers ready. You can, yeah. We incorporated a couple new ones, it looks like. Do y'all know how to do this? Okay. Rachel, I may need you to force over, okay. All right, let's pray. Let's get serious. Come on, let's get serious and pray. Father God, we thank you tonight, Lord, for this time of fellowship we've had. We thank you, Lord, for all you have provided for us today, just to have communion and fellowship together, just to come into the house of the Lord and sing and hear the praises, Lord. And just as Reggie said earlier, just to sometimes let a smile come out. Just to say hello, friend, and have a person say back to you, hey, friend. And so, Father God, we just thank you for our friends. We thank you for our Christian brothers and sisters. But, Lord, we pray for the lost. We pray for those who are out there that don't know you, that they may come to know you before it's too late. That's what church is about. We're here for those who don't know Jesus as much as we're here for those who do know Jesus. Because, Father, you told us to go out and disciple and to minister one another. So, Lord, thank you for tonight. Thank you for this service. And I just ask that in Christ's name, amen. Everybody, if you would, please, I'm going to turn this last piece over to Brother Dave. Let's give him a hand tonight, okay? Thank you,
God. Wow, what an evening this has been. And this brought back a lot of memories, being here tonight. Now, Brother Jimmy is really special to me because his uncle was our pastor when I was a little boy at Lawsonville Road Baptist Church. If anybody remembers the Reverend Gaddis Brown, remember Brother Gaddis? This is his nephew. I remember we missed church one Sunday. And I can't remember. We may have had to stay home to blow that poor kid's nose, like in that song, Excuses by the Kingsmen. I can't remember why, but by 12:30, Brother Gaddis was on the telephone with my daddy. We missed you. But what an evening, and I'm so glad I've got to see all the great, great Covington folks tonight, and those that are here visiting, we're really glad that you came. This has been wonderful. Thank you for being here. This is an evening I'll long remember. Let's pray. Thank you, Lord, for the privilege to fellowship, Lord, with believers. Thank you, Lord, for this wonderful privilege to hear Reggie and his family. What a blessing they've been. Lord, what we've heard tonight, we can take it with us on Monday and throughout the entire week. And just thank you all week long for the blessings of Sunday night, July 30th, 2023. Lord, I pray your blessings on this family. Meet and supply their needs. Bless this church and this good pastor here and his wife and all the Covington folks. God, we believe, I believe, that the best days lie ahead for Covington Wesleyan Church. And we thank you in advance for that. Thank you for loving us and caring for us. We pray you will go with us as we go to our respective homes. And Lord, for what we've experienced tonight, we give you all the glory in Jesus' name. And all God's youngins said,
Amen.
Amen. Good night.